Hey guys, welcome to part two of the camp stove installation kit for the 55-gallon drum. This is model number BSK-1000. So stay tuned, and we're gonna do some homework. Okay guys, thanks for sticking around. You'll see in part one of this series, we installed the door for off the camp stove kit. That worked swell-ish, as you've seen. We struggled with it a little bit, but we got it. This part, we are going to install the legs. Reason why I'm doing this step next rather than doing like the smoke stack adapter, what do they call that, the damper, putting the damper in, because on my particular stove I have a removable lid, and I understand that probably some of you won't have a removable lid, so right now I can put these legs anywhere I want, okay, right now, and then once I have these on, then I can align that dampener on top where I want it. So that's kind of what my goal is to put the legs on next, and then I'll put the dampener on. But so that's what you're gonna see in this video, is putting these legs on. Just a quick overview, I think it's gonna be kind of difficult. I mean, the first one's gonna be easy, bolted on. Second one, you gotta kind of line up, you know, so it's gonna sit right, you know, for the other set of legs. Because it comes with two sets of legs, you know, for front and back, okay? So that second set might be a little more tough to line up with the front ones. We'll see. We'll work through it, though. But, so without further ado, let's just get into it. Okay, guys. One thing to maybe pay attention to is your barrel. Just kind of take a quick glance around the barrel and see if there's any kind of dents. As you can see on my barrel, if you can see that real well, let's tilt you down a bit. I got a few dents in my barrel. You know, I could probably pound that out so it wouldn't be so much of a dent here, but I'm not going to worry about it. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to put my legs on this side then and make this the underside of the stove. So, you know, that way, I guess aesthetics, you know, you're not putting a big dent on top of the stove or something. Not that I don't know if it really matters. It doesn't matter, just the way it looks, I guess. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to put my legs where my dent, well, to put the dents on the bottom part of the stove. So let's get into it. I'm going to speed this video up. I don't want to take up too much of your time here, but I'm going to speed the video up, and you'll see me mount the first leg, and then we'll figure out what we got to do with the second leg. Okay guys, so we got one leg kind of loosely mounted on there. We got the four holes drilled and screws in them. One thing that I think these screws are designed to go, go up and in, and then not on the inside of the barrel. But, you know, I got a good, almost a half inch of bolt sticking up into the barrel. Well, that might kind of be a pain in the butt. When I'm cleaning out the barrel, you know, with getting there with the shovel, I'm gonna be hitting the bolts. So I think I'm gonna flip them around and put the nuts on the outside. That way you got more of a smooth surface in there. It's still gonna catch, you know, when you're trying to clean it out, but I don't think it'll be be less of a pain in the butt. So I think I'm gonna do that. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna flip them bolts around, and then I'm gonna get them tightened, get this whole foot tightened, and then we can start on the second one. So we're gonna speed it back up again, and be back when I got this all tightened. Okay guys, so first leg is on, all bolted in. I flipped them bolts around so it's not as much sticking out inside. Seemed to work good. So I guess we'll move on to the second one. Like I said, I'm not sure. Here, I'll tilt the camera down a bit. I'm gonna put this one down here. Okay, but the trick is, where do I put it? Like that, you know? I mean, I suppose I could put it on my sawhorses on the legs and then try to mark the holes. You could try that. All right, let's try that and I'll be right back with you. Okay, so that did work. I just put them on the sawhorses and it set the whole barrel right on the legs. Now I just marked one hole on each side. Now I'll pull the barrel back up and drill them out. Well guys, I had to reach way down in this barrel to tighten that up. So I'll just stop the camera right now and then I'll come back when I got it all put together. You guys get how them go on. So I'll be right back. Okay guys, so we got the second foot on. I'm not gonna lie, it was kind of a pain in the butt. Reason being is you gotta reach all the way to the back of the barrel to screw the screw in, but then you gotta hold the nut also. So you're kind of like this over top of the barrel. I honestly don't know how you would do that, how you would get back to the back of the barrel to put these nuts in, or bolts and nuts for the back legs without a removable top. I mean, if it was a sealed barrel and you only had to cut out the opening for the door, that'd be a pain in the butt to get back to them. I mean, I'm sure you could still do it, but. So anyway, that's my little rant for that. So let's set this up on its legs on the sawhorses and see how we did. Sawhorses, but it seems to sit good. I think that worked out pretty good. So guys, that'll be it for this part two section. We got the legs on, so we're good there. Next thing we'll do, and I'll get it out right now to kind of show you. Next thing is the dampener, which will go on something like that. You know, we're gonna have to drill another hole, which that might be kind of another pain in the butt, but we can do her. So that's gonna be that'll be part three of this. And I hope this helped you out. Keep following along in the series. Like I said, there's going to be, we're gonna turn this into a pool heater. So that's the end goal for this, but I'm gonna bring you along for each section of this build. So follow along, links in the description for future videos and also previous videos. Also a link in the description for this kit, this camp stove kit. It's an Amazon affiliate link. just click on it, check it out. But yeah, thanks for watching. I appreciate it, and I will see you on the next one.